Merle that, I said, Chad's daughter Merle, I said, they wouldn't be on stage, I said, you know, I said, there wouldn't be a Steve Wariner. I would not have had a career without Chad Atkins. He gave me my start and let me make records and took me into the old Studio B, RCA, back when it was a, and by the way, our condolence to Bill Porter's family. I know you heard about Bill passed away today, I think, and my condolences to his family, but you know, a chance for a young kid from Indiana and Kentucky to come down and make records with, you know, you're sitting in the studio thinking, man, I'm sitting here with Chad Atkins, you know, that's really incredible, and I'm deeply honored and, you know, just thrilled to get to be here today. But I wouldn't have a career, no question, without Chad Atkins. I also wouldn't have a career without the guy that I'm going to introduce you to, because he is the guy that I hounded him so bad that he took my tapes to Chet and introduced me to Chet and was the reason that I even got to meet him. And I'd love to bring him up and maybe play a couple tunes in honor of our pal, Chad Atkins. Would y'all give a great big hand to my hero and mentor also, Mr. Paul Yandell. Here he is. See, I'm glad that mic was off. They didn't hear it, you know. So.
Afraid I'll say something, I guess.
Chet, you say, go ahead, just shut up and sing, Steve. Just shut up, quit talking.
Mic test.
I said backstage, I said, Chet, Paul's not used to playing these hack versions of these Chet songs with somebody like me. He's used to doing it with the real deal, you know.
Let me see if I got my original.
This should be fun.
We'll see. What's that? I'm off the area. I ain't been doing this too long, about 50 years.
All right.
I guess I'm ready.
My side's ready.
What is it? Oh. Thank you. Steve something, I tell you.
It's fun.
If you look in the dictionary under great, you'll see his picture.
Oh, man. Thank you, Paul. Thank you. Maybe it's under something else. I don't know.
And I ain't kidding you either.
he's
one of the greatest.
I appreciate that.
In any category, great songwriter. That's where he makes all his money, writing songs. I ain't kidding you. He wrote some biggies.
Try to fool him another day is what I'm trying.
He's been through every Mel May book there is. So he's trying to put us all out of business, folks.
Yeah, right. I don't think
but
so.
But I'll be damned if I'm going to let him do it. What's that other old favorite that we was going to play before you came a legend? What was that? He said, don't say that.
A legend in my own mind, baby. I love it what Chet used to say. I just loved it. He would say, I get around Paul and start remembering all these things, but I love it. Chet would real, the way he would deliver it too, so, as you know, it was so dry and he just sucked you in, you know. I love it. He would say, he'd get ready to do a beautiful song. He would sit on the stool with his classical and he'd say, here's a song that we are going to do. It's a beautiful song and I'm hoping that it might be the national anthem of some small country someday.
Hey, Steve, awesome. I wanted to tell you.
That's awesome. And,
my son and I, Mac, have spent the week last weekend up at Mayfield, the old home place up there. And they had a terrible accident out at Mayfield. It's a little old town, you know. But the pool hall burnt down and left 15 people homeless. It was terrible.
I love it. A friend of mine yesterday, a friend of mine called me, and he called me and he says, man, I just checked into my hotel yesterday, and he said, I was pulling out the drawers, and he said, I pulled out the dresser drawer beside the bed, and he said, there was a Bible in it, and I took it out, and he said, I don't know, I just didn't have nothing to do. I was looking through it, and he said, a piece of paper fell out of the Bible, and it said, if you have an alcohol problem, and then said, do you have a drinking problem? Call this number. He said, so I called it, and it was a liquor store down the street.
Hey, Steve, what was this Chet said about your bass playing that time?
Well, true story, we were in Anchorage, Alaska playing a show, and Paul, myself, Tony Migliore was playing piano, and Randy Hauser playing drums, and Georgia Lund road mangling us up there, and we were in the middle of the show, great crowd, and so I'm over playing my little jazz bass, and Tony Migliore, and Tony's playing, just he's wearing it out on piano, and I'm just over, and Chet walks over to me. The benefit was for me only, no one else heard this in the whole world. That's what amazed me, is that he did this, but he walks over, and I'm that Tony's playing his butt off, and Chet bends over and goes, has anybody ever, it whispered in my ear so only I could hear it, has anybody ever told you you're the world's greatest bass player? And I go, no. And he goes, have you ever wondered why? And I goes, man. He just came all the way to Anchorage to bust me up here on stage. I don't know why. I had a friend, Paul, I think I told you too, but a new friend, Phil, he sent me I got in the mail the other day, and it's a CD of two Chet shows that were filmed in 1979 in Virginia. I think maybe it's Wolf Trap in Virginia, but I put it on, and it was 1979, and here Chet comes out and plays by himself, and then he says, I'm going to bring out a guy that's been playing with me for a long time, and he said he worked for so-and-so, he worked for Kitty Wells, he worked for the Louvins, he worked for and he worked at the post office for a while. I mean, it's just great. And he said, so I'm going to bring him out here. Yasser Arafat, here he is. And Paul comes out, he introduces Yasser Arafat. But anyway, I'm so thrilled to have two live shows, totally two complete shows on you could tell someone was sitting on the front row filming.
You
could
have told that, everybody be wanting it.
Yeah. No. No. It's time y'all shut up and play. You don't mind the talking, do you? I like all that. Can I tell one more story? Let me tell one more story. True, this is funny. I told this last year when we did our little pilot show, the little thing we did when the album came out at the Loveless. I told this, and it really is, I'd never told this story, but I was at Chet's house one day, and I was getting ready to leave, and I was driving a little Nissan pickup truck with a camper shell on it, and little had a King Cab little truck, and I was getting ready to leave, and Chet said, "Hey, before you go, would you mind doing something for me?" And I go, "Sure." And what is it? And he said, I would have done anything, probably. I didn't even ask what it was, but he said, "There's a wasp nest right up here." He said, "Right around the corner." He says, "I've got this spray. It shoots 50 feet or whatever." He goes, "Do you mind just spraying that on your way out?" And I go, "Sure." You know. So I walk around the corner of the house, and I look up and where the meat's there, and it was a hornet's nest. It wasn't a wasp. I know the difference. I mean, so I went, "Oh, crap." I didn't want to look like a wuss in front of my hero, so I go, "Yeah, give me that stuff." Shaking it, and I walk over, and I go, "You know what? This is not a good idea." And I looked around, and Chet was, and Leona were there, but they weren't there now. They had walked back in. So I go, we got my little truck, and I pulled it up off the driveway there up in the grass, and I thought, well, I'll have a little plan of attack, so I opened the door. I rolled the window down, and I get behind the door, and I'm looking out, the glass is halfway down, and I'm aiming it up, it's way up there, and I go, I just douse that. It's this big, it's like a football, you know. And so as soon as I do that, here they come, and I'm squatted behind my truck door, and I just dive into my truck, and I pull the door real fast, and as I'm rolling the window up, I'm hearing they're just hitting the glass. I go, "Oh no, they're gonna be in here with me," you know. And here's the clincher for me. After my heart slowed down a little bit, I looked around, and peeking around the corner of the house was a little head, two heads, Chet and Leona right here. They're looking around, and Chet was laughing. Anyway, that's what I thought. Uh-oh, I've got me some hornets in my truck with me. I'd made it. But anyway, we're gonna play you. I better shut up and sing and get her played, but. I'm going to attempt to, if I can do this and get through this. One of my very favorite things that Chet did back in the early 60s with Paul. And I think you said Jerry Reed played rhythm on this record, didn't he? And I just love this. I always wanted to learn this. And Chet, I have a cassette of Chet teaching me this in his office one day, or what little part I do know how to play. But we're going to try it for you. And it's called Blue Angel. So see if I can get through it. Thank you. guys. Good to see y'all. Thanks so much. Love you.